So, welcome to this new episode of Italian culture. Basically, there is Italian culture, traveling, a lot of stuff. And this episode is about something that I love. It's coffee. A lot of people love coffee. Yeah. What I would do without coffee. So, this episode is about three Italian ways to drink coffee that you don't know about. I'm sure you don't know about it. Let's see immediately what is number three. So number three is caffè ristretto. Let's see what that means. Oh, first of all, I want to talk a little bit about Italian coffee brand because in America you don't know this one. It's called Illy, like it's spelled. You see written on the cup of coffee. It's delicious. I love it. So try, if you are a coffee lover, probably you love South American coffee, Colombian, Brazilian coffee, delicious. But if you also love Italian coffee, you want to try Illy. It's my favorite. It's really good. In America, it's very common, very popular, Lavazza. They import Lavazza in the United States. Less common because they don't import it, I don't know why, is Pellini. Pellini is really, really good as well. It's a little bit stronger than Lavazza. And then there is a Splendid that is very similar to Lavazza. Splendid is very popular in Italy, like Lavazza. But my favorite is definitely Illy Caffè. He is strong like Pellini, but he has a retro taste that is a little bit bitter. Just a little bit, like a Brazilian coffee, but is a little bit more, I don't know how to explain, less strong, is not so. You should try it and tell me what you think. Illy Caffè, my favorite. So let's proceed with this. Let's see, this is caffè ristretto. You see, this is caffè ristretto. This is a regular espresso, caffè espresso. On the right, you see caffè ristretto. Basically, caffè ristretto is concentrated. They make an espresso using half of the water. So it's very concentrated and is a shot. It's a shot of energy. Usually when people feel tired, they get a caffè ristretto that is very strong to wake you up because you gotta work, you gotta study, and you need that. So here, just to let you see the difference, on the right, you have an espresso. On the left, ristretto, caffè ristretto is half of the water to make it stronger. That's what it is basically. So ristretto is half. And here you have, just show you, espresso, the regular one. On the right there is doppio. Doppio is just two espresso, one on the top of the other one. Ristretto is espresso, like I told you, with the half of the water, so it's stronger. Let's see now, number two. You love that one. This is caffè corretto with a shot of alcohol. That's what it is. You don't know, but next time you go to Italy, try. Go in a bar or cafeteria, because in Italy bar and cafeteria are the same thing. Ask for a caffè corretto. You will see. And it's very good when it's cold. So basically, caffè corretto is a coffee with a shot of alcohol. That's what it is. It's called caffè corretto. And they use many kind of alcohol to prepare caffè corretto. But the most common is this one that is called grappa and is very popular in Italy. Grappa is really, really strong. And it's like vodka. I think it's even stronger than vodka. And you know, in America you say 7 proof, you call them proof, okay? So 7 to 120 US proof, so it's really, really strong. They usually drink just a shot, and is originally from the north of Italy. It looks like it has been created by the monks. And there are many brands of grappa in Italy. If you want to try, just go online. I think you can find it. I'm gonna put all the links on the description so you can find all that stuff that I'm talking about, maybe online. And okay, usually they use to infuse with aromatic herbs. They infuse grappa with aromatic herbs like mint, of rosemary. It's really, really good. And this is according to the tradition of the monks that invented grappa for the first time. The monks used to add aromatic herbs. And this is caffè corretto. It's coffee with a shot of grappa or alcohol. Let's see what is number one. So number one is caffè macchiato. Let's see what is caffè macchiato. I tell you right away. So we see caffè ristretto. We saw caffè ristretto that is concentrated, okay? Shot of energy. Number two was caffè corretto. Coffee with a shot of alcohol. Caffè macchiato instead of coffee with a shot of milk. That's everything it is. Coffee with a shot of milk is called macchiato. So this is a macchia. In Italian, CH, you read it like a K, so you pronounce it macchia. In English, macchia is a stain. So basically, caffè macchiato, it means this coffee with a stain. A stain of what? A stain of milk. Look if it doesn't look like a stain. That's why they call it like that. And so, caffè macchiato is coffee with a shot of milk. That's all. You don't have coffee. It's not exactly coffee. It's espresso. I'm talking about espresso. It is the typical Italian coffee. Typical Italian coffee is espresso. So, you don't have to confuse caffè macchiato with caffè latte. Why? They are different. Caffè latte is coffee with a lot of milk. It's 50-50. It's a full, is a big cup, first of all, and there is a 50% coffee, 50% milk. So caffè latte is a coffee with a lot of milk. Instead, caffè macchiato is just a little shot of milk. So they are different in the proportions. So, you saw caffè ristretto, caffè corretto, I'm sure you're gonna try, you should, and caffè macchiato, you know what they are. At this point, I'm gonna tell you thank you, coffee lovers, or maybe I can say grazie, amanti del caffè.